We've had to adjust, certainly, you know, on the fly, but that's life. That's what we have to do. And that's exactly what President Trump wants us to do here. And we know that he can't be replaced. I mean, he's truly one of a kind. But we also know this, that the MAGA movement is not only President Trump. He's instrumental in it, of course, but it's not only him. So there are a lot of other really effective voices. We've taken to the airwaves, you know, with abandon over the last couple of days. We're launching today. We're calling it Operation MAGA. We're going to launch a lot of digital rallies. And then after the vice presidential debate on Wednesday, we're going to fan out across the country. A lot of us to host in-person events, to give speeches. We're going to do the best we can to provide content, to flood the zone with content. And again, none of us is Donald Trump, but we can still deliver Trump's message. And we're going to see, depending on his condition, what he can do via videotape, digitally, until he's ready to get out physically again. To answer your question about the polls, look, there are some polls that are alarming. There are some that are really reassuring. You know, for example, I know that the CNBC one was not good for us. But if you look, for instance, at Investor's Business Daily and Zogby, both of those national polls narrowed dramatically to very tiny Joe Biden leads. We don't in the campaign pay a ton of attention to national polls because, of course, that's not how our election is constructed. When we look at battleground state polls, I think here's the reality. Either camp could win most of these battleground states. And so I'm trying to not be a partisan for a second. I think that's an objective view, is that the battleground states are very tight in most polling, whether it's public or private polling. In the next 30 days, the reason I believe we're going to win these polls is we have the compelling value proposition of an American economy that is surging higher right now. And I know we still have a lot of work to do to get back to the heights of the Trump boom that we enjoyed in the earlier parts of this year. But the results are tangible, and there are very data-driven reasons to be incredibly optimistic about the trajectory of this economy. That's our most persuasive case to the American people, that they should rehire Donald Trump as our national CEO.